show must go on, even though the battery on the phone that I'm recording with is dying, so. I just want to show these clowns that I really haven't put on video yet. I think it's very interesting when people have clown phobias, because I don't really see the danger in it. But then again, there are people that climb heights that make me nervous, so I guess that's observation that a lot of it has to do with perspective. If you're getting into tattooing in the LA scene, there's people that draw a lot of clowns, gangster style. This clown here has a lot of things coming out of it, like faces or demons. I like this clown, actually. I like stuff that doesn't make sense. It's not the usual smile now, cry later. Finally able to comment on YouTube videos now. It's funny when there's a live stream videos on a plane. And You know, I don't find it very insulting if someone says that my work sucks or that my perspective is wrong. If you're one of those people, all I request is, even if you said it's ugly, it's stupid, just tell me why. I do enjoy having conversations back and forth. Or maybe I'm not too clear on my perspective. When I draw some of the religious, just the light, a little bitter. I'm gonna address some of that religious stuff, but just a lot of it was from reading and seeing documentaries about religion. So I base the base it off of that. When I draw stuff like this, it's it just reminds me of, like I said, of many things. I think at times we are our own worst enemy. We give these monsters we make these monsters come to reality because they're just, we convince ourselves to believe that they're really in the darkness. And that's totally natural because, you know, our ancestors in the past, when before we were, I think before we developed a clear language, you know, we were able to recognize dark shapes that moved, and then by recognizing them we were able to run away on time. You know, whatever that predator was or that other human from another tribe was. So we're able to detect or make out shapes out of the darkness. It's part of our survival instinct. Although, at times I do like, it's hard to say that those ghost stories are not real. You know, can so many people around the world be lying? Millions? Or millions of us just mistaking our instinct for an illusion. Who knows? One day that should be cracked, that mystery. I like watching science fiction or reading about science fiction more than I do that about celebrities or gossip shows. There's a show, old show, that used to be called the Twilight Zone. That freaked me out as a kid. I'm trying to think what that episode was called where Captain Kirk, what's his name? Okay, at least Captain Kirk from Star Trek, he was in an episode from Twilight Zone. And he once had seen a monster on the wing of a plane while it was in flight. And that always made me, as a kid, that made me believe that those monsters were real. Because it doesn't straight out say on Twilight Zone that, you know, what you're watching is a show based on fiction. It doesn't say that clearly out there. Especially if you're a kid and you're just up late watching TV, because that's all that I was conditioned to do at the time if I was awake. I do wonder if my stuff won't give anyone nightmares. Don't let that happen. It's just art. Unique art. Art that isn't common. This black prism pencil, I like using it a lot. Not a lot, but as overkill, but it definitely helps give drawings depth. It makes the shadows, I think it enriches them. Gives it a cool tone.